afternoon to everyone. We start although I know some students, especially from science computing, have a problem of overlapping, so maybe they will arrive late or they are not here. Thank you for being here. Very shortly, we will present an initiative that I think the majority of you already know, which is cross-boundary process, or as you may know, lake policy. This is an interdisciplinary course between science computing, management engineering, and environmental engineering, in which we work with companies. This course gives you 5 credits, and this is a very technical element for management engineering and science computing, computing engineering, is in the study plan, so you may see in the web application. For environmental engineering is more informal, so you can include in the study plan, but just need to go to the student plan, which is the goal of this initiative. Working with other disciplines, with students from other disciplines, but with companies. And you work here in Polytechnic, contrary to what you can do with the internship where you are in company. You go in company just to see where they are, maybe to see some processes, but the main work will be held in Polytechnic. Just to make this feasible, compatible with your study plan, because you will have other goals. And the development of cross-boundary process is across one major element, which is a project, then some seminar lesson that we do across the year, plus a final workshop. The central element is the business case, the project in which we work. Every year we try to improve the selection of company and organization which provide the cases. Because, as Claudia knows that participated, the quality of the support that the company provides is really relevant also for the outcome that students can get. And this year we have already 6 cases. We are a bit uncertain about the 6 because with previous experience now we are very selective. And we have a 7 case just in the background if we refuse the 6. It's a mix. The cases are a mix between private and public company. Just to give you an example, we have 2 consultancy companies that participated in previous year. And we have 2 small companies. And we have a theater who is doing with us a particular initiative devoted to younger people, just to near them to the opera. This is an interesting project. When do we start? We will start in October, and in particular, we will have the initial event in which we present the cases, and you will select your preference, you will give your preferences, on Monday, the 13th of October, which is the starting day of the new academic year. In the morning, we do not teach, we just avoid doing all the other courses, and we do together the welcome day and the presentation of lessons. Then, the next week, we start. We don't have yet the timetable for the new courses, but I may say that our weekly meeting will be at last year on Thursday at 5:30. In this way, you just close your normal courses and we have this 2-hour meeting with companies or with the teacher. I am from Management Engineering, Marco Bravilla is from Computing Engineering. And the teacher from Environmental Engineering unfortunately had a problem coming to Como and this is Domenico Biaggi, so I apologize for not being here. You will meet us every week, while you will have a bi-monthly meeting with companies. They come every 2 weeks. During this period from October to February 2015, you develop your project. We will have a an interim presentation, which is Maddalena helped me in the
18th of December.
Of December. It seems that we are a bit early with this, but we know that international students from other countries plan very early their travel back to their country. So just remind, if you participate, that the 18th of December we have this presentation. Then the final assessment will be divided into the academic assessment, which will be done by ourselves, the teacher, plus an important actor, the tutor. You will be assigned as a group a tutor who is usually a PhD student or a research fellow, follow you during these 5 months, and is a sort of connection with company to easy communication and so on. The groups are mixed, and management engineering are more numerous, so we have more management, but usually we have 3-4 from management and 1-2 from science, computing, and environmental engineering, according to the type of project. As I said, we have other two elements. One is the final workshop, in which you present. You present your case to a jury. And this is the second assessment. We have two pillars, which are connected but separated in term evaluation. We will provide a grade from 18 to 30. Usually marks are very high because the commitment in this project is usually very high. But on the other side, at the final workshop, there will be a prize for the best group. And the prize will be assigned not by ourselves, but by a jury composed by entrepreneurs and academics, not from our group. So it's a sort of separate things. The prize, I don't know this year, but in the last 3 years, has been a ticket of €500 for each member of the winning group. And then we have a second prize, which is €250 for each member. This semi, instead, we have a third line, which was not so emphasized last year, but this year we are thinking of just to revitalize this element, which are seminar across the year. What we want to test this year is to do very few seminars, but on soft skill. So not on topics, because we know that it's very difficult because you come from different disciplines, but we will try to provide a seminar on soft skill, just working in groups, presenting this type of issues. This is very important. This initiative is for a selected number of students. We have 5 members for each case. So to a multiplication, you have 5 times 6. So we will select 30 students. At this link, you find the application form. The parameter on which we select the students are, first of all, the average, the GPA. But then there is an important part, which is the motivation level. In some way, if you have a very high average, you are on the safe side. But this is an initiative in which we need the commitment from students. So for us, it's very important that you show that you are very committed to this initiative, especially if your average is not very high. Just let us know why we should involve you in this initiative. And regarding the pass-by word, I know that usually some students don't read email sent by the student office. So if you have the possibility to contact your friend or so on, just if you can pass this link, because the deadline is mandatory. And at the end of May, we close application, because we need the time to see this. The motivation letter and so on. Do you have questions? Because I moved to another initiative just for management engineers. Mark, do you want to say something?
No, simply for the computer science students, basically, which are I see some faces I know here. Anyone else? Okay. Okay. So, as Michela said, for the computer science student, obviously every group will be multidisciplinary. Every person will bring his own expertise, and his own role will be on the topic he's expert about. But one of the main advantages is also to do some sort of cross fertilization between the people in the group. So if we manage to start learning maybe something about computer science and vice versa. For computer scientists, I see one of the most advantages here being the part about soft skills, the part of, that we don't cover in our courses, and at the end it shows in the profile of the people at the end of the track, because you learn a lot of technical things, but you may miss some aspects on organization and management, group work, and stuff. So this is one of the aspects. And the other aspect from your side is you will get in touch with real companies and real cases that we need to address. This may imply also some, so it's not just meeting and chatting, there's also some concrete work to be done. At the end, you will be evaluated on what you do. This is true for every role in the group. For computer science, it will be typically on computer science related matters. Okay? I would say if you have other questions or anything, I'll be here now and you can get in touch with me.
Thanks. Question?
Yes. I've checked the application form and was written that the motivation letter needs to be short. Can I ask, like, how short it's meant to be?
How many words, Maddalena, do you have?
Let's consider, let's say, half A4 page. I mean, you have to do not be so long, but to summarize why you should be inside the Lake Poly School. Mm-hmm. Especially because you have to consider that from the student from the past edition, one of the main reasons is not just to challenge yourself in a multicultural and multi-competences environment, but also will be a grow-up by professional point of view and human point of view, because in these 6 months, you have really to challenge yourself also, as we said, in some skill. You know that your group is going to present in Aula Magna then, in front of the full Aula Magna. So this one is also one skill that you have to show us, that you can summarize in this half page, one page, why you should be there. So too many words, you will just, lose the concept. This is also a critical point.
If I think it, characters, I would say 400 characters, something like that.
I think that the best that we got sometime was just a two sentence, but very pointing and illuminating, yeah. Also, you can add the CV, so remember that you can switch between these two parts. One is the motivation, one is show what you did already.
This can be very important, but also in the motivation letter, to show your background, because especially for, but even for polytechnic students, now we have this possibility in which you do the bachelor in management and then you do the master of science in science computing, vice versa. If you have a different background, this is for us very important, because otherwise for the fourth we think that you are science computing, management engineering. We don't think that at the bachelor you did something different. So this can be evaluated for us. Okay, if I may take another 5 minutes, I present another initiative. This is less selective because we have space for 55 students, so we have larger space. And this is devoted for management engineering. This is a course, Complex Decision Making, which is held in a workshop modality, which means that we have only 2 weeks of interns teaching. It's a sort of interactive course, experiential course, in which we do a bit of soft skill. I'm not a teacher in this course. The teacher is Ernst Braun from TU Delft University, so I'm presenting this course because now he is in the Netherlands, he's not here. And this course tries to teach us how we can manage complex projects and complex settings. in which we have more than one organization, in which you have a public and private organization, and in which the goal is usually a long-term impactful project, like the construction of infrastructure, train, airports, this kind of project. The first week is devoted to the multi-actor perspective. The second week, which is from March 2015, is devoted to multicultural issues. Also for this initiative, it is important for us to have your application. Last year, all the students who applied had the space to participate. We did a sort of self-selection, but it's important because for us, we have this limit due to the space of the room. And the topic, as I said, is this, and we do a lot of group work and simulation. In particular, Hans comes with two actors from the Netherlands who simulate with you being in a complicated situation. A different link for this application, again, the same deadline, so you don't make confusion. And this is a technical issue, but it's important. The mark is registered in June 2015. So this may be important if you want to graduate in April 2015. If you do this course, you don't get the credit from this course by April 2015. It doesn't mean that you cannot do the course, but you don't receive the credit. Okay? Instead, if you want to graduate in July, December 15, no problem. Just the problem for April 2015. Do you have a question on that? Good. Now, thank you very much. Of course, Marco and I, Magdalena, Antonella are here for your question because maybe you want to have a more personal link with us. I didn't introduce myself. I apologize. My name is Michela Carnavolti. Marco is Marco Brambilla. Our emails are always the same, name.surname@polini.it. So if you want information, you can write us. Maybe we are not very quick in answering, in replying, but if we don't reply in 1 week, send again because the email is lost